Hello and good morning. So for today's lab, what I'm going to show you is on how to create an application that does not rely too much on edit text or text field. So here you can see that an application, right? You can, it could react to the sidebar, okay? Without having to rely solely on edit text. So you, as you already learned in the class, relying too much on edit text can cause confusion and also can cause a lot of mistake by the user who are easily distracted. So using edit text too much inside your mobile application can introduce many mistakes, and this can also make your user fed up in using your application. So this is how you avoid using too much of edit text or text field inside your application and make your application much more friendlier. Okay, to proceed with replacing the edit text with sidebar in order to increase its usability, we need first to rewrite back the code and also to modify the user interface. So if you double click here, you have a discount read user interface. Okay, you may delete this, right? Okay, and then you add another widget which is sidebar. You can put it over here. Okay, and then do not forget to anchor this sidebar over here. Okay, we have already configured this. Okay, this is the ID sidebar. Then we have to ensure that it is friendly enough in Fitts law. 16 dp left and then right. Okay, for this one, I think I made a mistake. I have to remove this. The sidebar must be at the bottom. Okay, so that it would be much more flexible. Okay, just like this one. Okay, next, I need to go to the programming part. Okay, notice that it become red because we have already removed ET discount. Okay, what we need to do is to remove the ET discount over here and replace it with sidebar. Okay, sidebar. Okay, sidebar. You do not forget to input it on by pressing alternate enter. Okay, can replace here sidebar. Here it would be sidebar. Okay, sorry. S-E-K, sidebar. Right, here would be also sidebar. Okay, I have to remove here. Okay, I have to take here sidebar dot get progress. Okay, get progress. Okay, this is one of the easiest part, right? Okay. Okay, you only have to get this progress. Okay. So inside this card. So it should be working, right? It should be working. The sidebar should be working. If it's not, it will just crash. Okay, you can see that this sidebar is functioning. So when you type over here, okay, press calculate, it would be able to calculate the discount. Okay, however, this sidebar have a weaknesses where when you move around this sidebar, it doesn't update the discount. Alright, the discount display over here. Okay, it doesn't update the discount display. So what you need to do is to ensure that when you move this slider, it will also update the discount. Okay, update the display discount. So you need to look into a listener. You need to implement a listener for progress change from the sidebar. So if you use a button, you have on click listener. So in a button on click listener, okay, the system will listen for a button click. Okay, listen for a button click, and then it will perform certain tasks inside button click. So for sidebar, okay, you can do also the same. So if you put a sidebar, you use this, okay, sidebar listener. Then you leave a space over here, you type a new on sidebar listener, and then you can get the progress either from sidebar or progress. You can type here like this, sidebar, so get progress int int progress. Okay, and put over here, and then you can here TV discount, output it from a TV discount dot set text, put over here plus sidebar sorry progress. Okay, so you can retest back. Okay, this is about the variable. Okay, it is already defined, so we can put here as okay, C progress. Okay, C progress. You put here a character C. Okay, it already defined here. So we can see over here. So it's already updated. Okay, when you move it around. Okay, the only thing is that it doesn't calculate. Okay, it doesn't calculate automatically. So how to make sure that it can calculate automatically? Okay, so in order to ensure that it can calculate automatically is by adjusting this method to perform the calculation, just like when you click the button, right? You click the button. So the most easiest way is to copy this and then repeat back inside this repeat the calculation inside this method. But the most sensible one is to create a method. So you can put here a method. Okay, inside Java you can create a method, method to calculate discount. Okay, calculate discount over here just like this one, right? Okay, over here. So method to calculate discount. So at the end of this class, okay, you can put here public or at this void. Okay, calculate discount, okay, just like this one. Okay, and then over here you have on click, just copy here. Okay, copy something like this. Okay, you put it back, right? You put it back, right? You put it back, and then you just rerun the application and see if it could work. Okay, 200. Okay, thus it could work. Right, something like this, it could work. So it's not that hard if you know how to program in Java or have learned how to use Java. So this is just a basic Java, and you delete this, and anyway, okay, inside here and then type calculate discount. Okay, so this is much more cleaner code. Okay, you can produce a much more cleaner code in your application. So you can come here, something like this. And then over here, if you press click on calculate, and then on progress change, right here, calculate discount. So that's all for today. Okay, I've already shown you how to replace the edit text with sidebar, and then show you on how to make it automatically calculate the discount. Okay, calculate the discount through the use of on progress change or on sidebar change listener. Okay, you use this listener to perform automatic calculation, and then secondly you can also use it to calculate it using button. Okay, using button just like this one, and you can also use button. That's all for our lab today. We'll seeing you on the next segment.